My name is Jonathan Cagan. I am professor of mechanical engineering. Generally, I work in the area of design and innovation, theory, methods, and practice. Our goal is to more fundamentally understand how people design innovative systems and products, and also how people react to those systems and products so that we can create better tools, methods, and also a more fundamental understanding of what it takes to create innovations for the marketplace. This work entails computational algorithms and methods for innovation and creativity. We look at cognitive bases for how people think as they're designing or as they react to designs. Most recently, we've also been looking at fMRI mappings of the brain to understand what regions of the brain are active during this type of decision making. I also look at methods of practice so that we can implement what we've been learning and also the other research that we do so that we can create methodologies that people can apply when they're designing products. One particular project that we've been focused on for several years is understanding the aesthetic preferences that people have to different types of products. In other words, what we can do is mathematically capture what an individual prefers in terms of what the form or shape of a product looks like. We capture this mathematically so that we can then generate new products that you or whoever we've captured that information from would prefer over all the other options that we could generate. The way we do this is a variation of conjoint methods, where we look at continuous variation of the shape or forms, and then we can capture exactly what part of that shape in combination with all of the other aspects of that overall aesthetics or form of that product give you the best preference, the one that you like the best. The goal is to understand how to design products that people prefer. The implications of that are people are more personally satisfied with the products that they would then use and purchase. And that has positive implications for companies and for the marketplace. My collaborators on the visual conjoint work are Peter Boatwright, who's a professor of marketing in the Tepper School of Business, and Seth Orsborn, who's now in the business school at Bucknell University. We have a patent pending on this work. This work extends our fundamental understanding of the emotions that people have toward the products. And overall, our goal is to balance the emotions that one gains from interacting with that product, in this case visually, with the performance of that product. So technically, we think of the balance between form and function of a product. This work would have applications for physical product design, but also for layouts of websites, or also even store layouts. Most recently, we've extended this work to bring in some moral decision-making, in particular by looking at issues of sustainability. So when you think about balancing the aesthetics and the function of performance, then you start to look at the implications of the impact of the carbon footprint, for example. How does that change the decision-making that people have? As you look at products, you can see them differently, knowing that all of the thought that goes into creating the product isn't just functional, but it's also the aesthetic and emotional aspects as well. And that all of that is taken into account and thought through by the developers of that product.